What's up, beauty? Short break from the Premier League for the Spurs career as we jump into EuroLeague against a team that I cannot pronounce. Zulit-Wurlum. Not really sure who this random team is, but I'm going to go ahead and assume, judging how this match went, that they are a lot better than me. Look at that goal. Tic-tac-toe. Here you go. How do you do? 1-0, 7.5 in. And if losing to these randoms wasn't enough, I'm going to go ahead and suffer some very, very bad injuries. There goes Adebayor. He's down. That'll be a sprained ankle in 4 weeks of your time. He's out. So that sucks. The injuries wouldn't stop there. I already got one striker out. Why not two? There goes Soldado. And I can't remember what his injury is, but it's 4 months. 4 months. So now I'm down two strikers. Kane is only rated 68 in this game, so if you thought we were in trouble now, it just got a lot worse. Was in good shape, only down 1-0 at the half. Plenty of time for a comeback, right? This Randy McDaniel team said, no. 2-0, 49 minutes in. So we'll just forget that game ever happened. On to something a little bit more exciting. Welcome back to the Premier League. It's the North London Derby. Derby, whatever you guys want to call it. I call it the Derby. Arsenal-Tottenham. Not too much confidence after that disgusting EuroLeague game, but look at the pass. The ball over to Paulinho. Goal! Playing without any true strikers up top, a massive early goal in the 17th minute, 1-0 Tottenham. But how long would that last, you ask? Not very long. Arsenal catches me on the counterattack. Now, I'm playing a 5-4-1 without any true strikers up top. Thought I would just add an extra center back to help out with the defense, but Arsenal says that does not matter. They break it down anyway, and it's 1-1 right before halftime, a devastating goal to concede right before the half. Late in the game, going into injury time, I don't give up here. Spurs don't give up. We're the greatest football team in the land. We're going to get a corner kick right at stoppage time, and look at this beauty. The drama. Paulinho! Oh my god, and he saves it, and they clear it, and they get a 1-1 draw. We return to White Hart Lane for another Premier League match against West Bromwich Albion, and this was the most boring game ever, but we're going to get a late one. The entire match was really, really boring. No chances really for either team, just extremely defensive, but we're looking for a late goal to get this W. Vertonghen is gonna take it to the corner. Now, we have not played well at White Hart Lane all season. We need this 3 points, extremely bad. Kabul to Dembele, he scores! The final match of this episode is going to be a EuroLeague Match Day 2 against RB Salzburg. We got destroyed in our first EuroLeague match. We need this one. And once again, we're late into the match with no goals for either side. I feel like my defending is getting better, but if you guys could tweet me some tips and tricks or something to be able to break a defense down on world-class difficulty, I would really appreciate that because it's just getting frustrating. Like, my controller wants to get thrown every game. But look at this! Can't quite get the header to go in the right direction, but I keep possession, and I feel like I got him broken down. I'm gonna make a beautiful move. Paulinho! Go, 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 go! I do believe that warrants a 10-man celly, because we do not need to drop our first two matches in EuroLeague and stare elimination in the face, not even halfway through group play. Beautiful goal by Paulinho, or terrible goaltending. You decide. I'm happy either way. Would I fall victim to a late goal by the computer? No! Laura says, no. But look at this. This is my most beautiful goal of the early season so far. Watch this ball. Eriksen is onside, and he scores. But this is FIFA, so if you think that you're going to escape with a 2-0 win, a clean sheet, and help your goal differential from that 3-0 spanking you took in match day 1, you thought wrong. But we will hold on for the very important 3 points, and I just want to give a quick thank you to our sponsors for this video. Today's video is sponsored by Opinion Outpost, a site where if you're 18 years of age or older, you can earn cash, iTunes gift cards, Amazon gift cards, just for giving your opinions and surveys. Research companies need your opinions on topics like food, TV, movies, new products, and politics. And there's a $10,000 cash quarterly prize drawing for active members. Each time you participate in a survey, you get your name in the entry for the drawing, and there's no limit to how many times you can get your name in the drawing. It's free to join, and emails from Opinion Outpost will appear in your promotions tab on Gmail, so click that link in the description below and get started today. Earn yourself some easy money to pay for all those awesome games that are coming out this fall. Have yourself a beautiful rest of the day, and I will ABC ya.